Nicole arrives a half hour early every day. She's not a morning person, but who is at 17? After hitting the snooze button a few times, she rolls out of bed and looks in the mirror. It's her first disappointment of the day. Her mom thinks she's beautiful. Her dad thinks she's cute as a button, but all Nicole sees are the little imperfections that make walking to school every day a nightmare. So she gets there early and disappears into the background.
Zach lives with his dad in a two-bedroom at the gas station. It's not as bad as you think. Pizza for breakfast, pizza for lunch, donuts for dinner. His mom lives across town. She got the house. Oh, four bedrooms, stainless steel appliances, and granite countertops as far as the eye can see. Zach visits on weekends, but he doesn't like the stainless steel and granite. His dad says they're just like his mom. Nice to look at, but impossible to live with.
The morning Laura turned 16, she had her driver's license in less than an hour. It's true she has a lead foot, but that's what people have come to expect from her. Accelerating has always been her specialty. She walked early, talked early, developed early. She leaves everyone in her rearview mirror. But there's something hot on her trail that no pedal to the metal can outrun. Laura has leukemia. She just doesn't know it yet. Caitlin is in love. In love with the trees, in love with the birds, in love with the sunset. Every night, she sits on her front stoop and watches the sun touch the horizon. When the bright yellow ball sinks out of view and the sky changes color, she says this prayer. "Thank you for today," she says. She's not sure if anyone's listening, but she says it anyway. She hopes that someone, someday, will look at her the same way that she looks at the sunset and say, "Thank you."
I'm not gonna lie. Tyler is pretty awesome. Question, which of the following is his best feature? His arms, his abs, his glutes? Answer, all of the above. What's his secret? No problem. Push-ups? Crunches and squats. Unfortunately, not everyone thinks Tyler is so awesome. Oh, he could wallpaper the entire school with detention slips. But what his teachers fail to recognize is that detention is bad, bad is sexy, and all roads lead to awesome.
Jessie has this game she likes to play. She can look at any food item and tell you the exact number of calories in it. Starbucks makes it easy because the price of the really calories just take away the decimal. Cheese croissant, 340 calories. 410 for a banana muffin. Peanut butter cookie, 480, and her personal favorite, a Fendi Java chip mochaccino blended cream. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. 590 calories. Boom, breakfast.
Morgan knows all about being different. When he was 5, he learned a different way to tie a shoelace. Two bunny ears was his favorite. When he was 10, he learned a different way to ski. He stuck to the bunny hill. Now he spends all of his time with his pet rabbit. People think Morgan is weird, and not a day goes by when he doesn't have to hear all about it.
Sam remembers when boys were gross, nap time was stupid, and the worst possible thing that could ever happen was dropping an ice cream cone on the ground. So, what the hell happened? Sam is knee-deep in SAT scores, college applications, and everything else that makes life complicated. She just wants to go back to a time when things were easy and she had time for herself.
Autumn.
Temperature drops.
Leaves change.
Backpack's ready.
Pencil sharpened.
Senior year.
First day of school.
Mom always told me it's what's on the inside that matters. It didn't matter if a person was overweight, had pimples, had brown hair or red hair, or if they're tall or short. So long as a person is nice and kind, they'd be loved. Beauty comes from the inside, she said. But on the first day of school, when I walked into gym class and found everyone staring at me, I realized something. What a load of crap! It turns out, beauty totally comes from the outside. It's ugly that comes from within.
Hey, yo, duck face!
What?
Quack!
What are you talking about?
Quack, quack, quack!
Stop it!
Nice picture, Daffy.
Don't call me that.
You prefer Donald.
My name is Nicole.
I thought so.
Why are you being so mean?
You are despicable.
See what I mean? On the outside, beautiful. Inside...
ugly. Hardly describes the way Mom treats my dad. She's brutal. Sugar in his gas tank, stealing his mail, spying on him, and let's not forget the time that she threatened him with a shotgun. It's not like he did anything to deserve it. I mean, she's the one that should be sorry. With a little help, she was.
So, did you do it?
Let's just say that she got the, open concept living room she always wanted.
And what are you gonna do if she finds out it was you?
Well, I hope she finds out it was me.
What?
Why else do you think I did it?
Really?
She needs to know that she's not the only one in this family who's mad.
Got it. Loud and clear.
Not a very pretty picture, but it's an honest.
Picture day. It's only the most important day of the year. And I'm sort of known for having super amazing hair. I mean, like, my mom's a hairdresser. I always have the latest style. This year, I was thinking up. But down and to the side is what's in right now, so that's what we did. And now I'm not so sure. I really like it up. God, so many decisions.
Excuse me, but what are you so worried about?
How can you say that? It's picture day.
We're 17. Isn't every day picture day?
I just hope I bought the right dress.
It's fine.
Fine? That's not good enough. I'd want my kids to come across my yearbook someday and say, what was she thinking?
Calm yourself.
So?
So what?
Is this a what was she thinking kind of dress?
No, but this is a what was she thinking face.
This is so exhausting.
Well, maybe you should take a pill.
No, really, I think I'm gonna faint.
Laura, you don't look so good.
Me or the dress?
You're drenched in sweat, you gotta sit down.
That was the day my whole world changed. Suddenly, I wasn't smile for the camera, Laura. I was
sick and tired of studying. If I have to look at another textbook about World War II, I'm gonna grow an itty bitty black mustache. But if I don't study, I won't get into the school I want. And if I don't get into the school I want, I won't get the job I want. And if I don't get the job I want, I might as well learn how to flip burgers now. Must stay awake.
Holy cow, Sam, think you got enough caffeine there?
Who wrote that list?
What list?
The list!
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Think, woman, the list! They even made a movie about it!
All right, that's it, Sam. I'm cutting you off. No more caffeine for you.
I know who wrote the list. It's just I'm so tired right now. All I can think of is Qui-Gon Jinn, and that's not even right. Or is it? Are Jedi's German?
I don't think so.
I need to pass this test.
Sam, it's Mr. Howe's class. Everyone's gonna pass the test.
I don't mean pass. I meant ace it. I have dreams.
Hey.
Schindler.
I have dreams too.
Schindler's List.
I'm not stupid.
Thank God.
Wait. Star Wars was about World War II?
I never did end up going to sleep. I passed the test, but I was so groggy, I totally messed up the essay question. I'm just glad Mr. Howe graded it on a sliding.
Scales are the worst. Eat 4,000 calories on Monday, long after you've forgotten if it was a cheeseburger
or a hot dog? The scale reminds you it was both. And then on Friday, the cheesy fries and onion rings appear.
Why are you going on a diet? Seriously, you look perfectly fine to me.
You don't want to talk.
I don't understand.
Please, you put away a whole bag of Doritos and it never shows.
That's not true.
It's like you have a hidden trap door that opens up at night and lets out all the carbs.
You're not fat.
Not yet, and I intend to keep it that way.
We can go to the gym together.
Ugh.
Or play volleyball.
I hate sports.
I'm just throwing out ideas. Like, I think a crash diet is a little extreme.
So is having to buy 2 seats on an airplane.
Just saying.
165 ways to lose weight. 165 books on how to lose weight. 165 pounds. Ready, set.
Go get your own girlfriend, I says to him, and then boom! I decked him right in the face. Oh, you should have seen it. It was beautiful. Oh, he's down on the ground. He's crying like the big baby he is. Finally gets up and his face is just caked in gravel. What can I say? Some artists, they paint with a brush. I paint with my fist.
That was crazy.
Totally. Check it.
How many stitches?
16.
That's all?
I know. Not even close to my record.
But I saw his face. There's at least like 50 of them.
That's what I thought.
And you?
Are you kidding me? Come on. Stitches are for babies.
Yeah.
But the best part of it all is?
What?
I ain't never seen that girl before in my entire life. I just wanted a reason to deck him, you know?
Since when do you need a reason?
Hey, I just didn't like the way you looked at me, you know?
Totally.
Hey, Nick. You know, ever since you dropped that whole good girl act, you're pretty cool.
Thanks.
Never suited you anyway.
No. It didn't.
So what? I got suspended. That's supposed to be a punishment? Girls love it when a guy is bad. Plus, it gave me tons of time to work on my amazing...
Absolutely not! There is no way I'm sending my picture to a guy just because he asked. Seriously, guys need to get with the program. Girls want candy and flowers and notes in her locker, not some low-res picture of a sunken chest. And if this guy thinks he's getting a picture of my chest, he's far more delusional than I thought.
So are you gonna do it?
No. There is nothing romantic about a hard drive filled with dirty pictures.
Romance is overrated.
No. Romance is underrated.
Yeah, tell that to my parents.
I have this hope. And I know it's crazy. That there's this guy out there waiting for me. Only he doesn't know he's waiting for me. But I know he's waiting for me, and the fact that he doesn't know he's waiting for me is what makes all this waiting more romantic than I could possibly express.
No, I think you expressed it quite clearly.
Don't laugh.
What if he doesn't exist?
He exists.
But if he doesn't.
He does!
If he doesn't, won't you be disappointed?
Don't you see? He could be anyone. He could be the guy walking his dog down the street. He could be the guy sitting next to me on the bus. He could be...
What?
He could be you.
Oh, now you're making it impossible not to laugh.
No, but seriously, wouldn't it be the most romantic thing if the perfect guy was right in front of me all along and I just didn't see it?
You watch too many movies.
Maybe I do watch too many movies. Maybe I'm expecting too much. Maybe one picture wouldn't hurt. I just can't bear the thought of ending up with...
Nobody ever sits with me at lunch. It's not as bad as it sounds. I'm not craving attention. I wouldn't have to take 1,000 pictures of myself every single day just to prove that I exist. Hey world, look at me. Notice me. Love me. Me, me, me.
When did the world become so self-centered? The way I see it, the word selfie is two letters away from selfish.
Is that seat taken?
No.
Do you mind if I sit there?
Please, go ahead.
Thanks.
So, what's going on?
Huh?
Got any plans for tonight?
I'm sorry. Do you mind if we just not talk? I'm just really tired right now, and I just needed a quiet place to sit where no one would bother me.
Oh.
Hey, when the bell rings, can you wake me up?
Of course.
Thanks.
Look at me. Notice me. Love me. Oh well, I still got time. After all, it's only
winter.
Snow falls.
Icicles form.
Mittens return.
Snowballs attack.
Angels appear.
Christmas.
December 25th was the day our bachelor's life came crashing to an end. Dad's new girlfriend moved in. And just like that, she inserted herself into my life the same way a splinter inserts itself under a fingernail.
Hey man, is she nice at least?
When Dad's around, yeah. But when he's gone, it's a whole other story. The other day, she took down all my stuff in the living room and put up these ugly porcelain angels.
You have to smash these.
What's your solution to everything?
Because it works.
Everything was so perfect until she came along. Now she's always asking where I'm going and what I'm doing. I called her on it this morning, and she actually told me to get down on my knees and pray for forgiveness.
It's just gross, man.
If it happens again, she'll be the one to need a prayer.
Hey, man, just tell your dad, man.
Like he'd care. His brain is no longer the one making the decisions.
Man, you gotta do what I've been telling you. Show them angels who's boss.
And I did. The next day, I was sent packing. Although I'm not sure what's worse, living with her or living with...
Mom?
That's it. Okay. No.
I'll take it from here. As I was saying, you know, my mom drove me to every single doctor's appointment. It didn't even matter if there was a rainstorm or a blizzard or even a cancellation. She'd yell at the nurses to find an opening if necessary. And it was often necessary, which I didn't like at all. I just hate being the reason my mom is sad.
Hey, Laura, how come you're wearing oven mitts?
Oh, these? These aren't oven mitts.
They sure look like oven mitts.
I only wish I was taking brownies out the oven. These are to keep my fingernails from popping off!
Huh?
If you want to go, I totally understand.
No. I said I'd be here. I want to be here.
It's the chemo. Apparently, some people's fingernails curl up and pop off, so they give you these frozen mitts to prevent that from happening.
Are you scared?
Scared? No.
Really?
Caitlin, a person can only be scared of things they can't control. Trust me, I got this.
I'm really glad to hear you say that.
The truth is, I was scared. I am scared. But what's the point of having two people scared when it only has to be
111 pounds? (sighs) 111 stairs I can climb, 111 dresses I can wear. 111 boys at
school was driving me crazy. So I ditched the books for one night. One stupid night. And one night is all it takes to change everything. Things got totally crazy and I lost all of my judgment. I wasn't thinking at all. And once you send something into cyberspace, there's no taking it back.
So what are you gonna do?
I don't think there's anything I can do. Damage has been done.
Come on, it's not like we all haven't done it.
But we don't all have pictures to prove it.
I think you're making much too big a deal of this.
No, I'm not. Caitlin is friends with Tyler, and Tyler's friends with Nicole, and Nicole's uncle is the dean of admissions at the school I'm dying to get into.
Maybe he won't see it. Maybe he won't care.
He saw it. And he definitely cares. He printed a copy and faxed it to my dad.
Who uses a fax machine anymore?
That's not the point. The point is, he's unsure that I have the dedication it takes to be a student at his school. His school, like he owns it or something.
You're the most dedicated person I know.
Yeah, but a picture says 1,000 words, and the 1,000 words he got say otherwise.
So, now what?
That was a good question. Now what? You have no idea how much I just want to bury my head under a blanket and play with my dolls like I used to when I was...
Little is the new big. Cars used to be big. And now they're small. Cell phones used to be enormous. And now they're tiny. The world used to seem so big. And now it's small.
I don't get what you're saying.
Fine then. Take music, for example. It used to be you need a grand orchestra in order to listen to music. Then they managed to put into a machine. It got even smaller when they invented the record, and then cassettes, and then CDs. Now, music doesn't even exist anymore, just the idea of it exists. It's waiting out there somewhere, waiting in the cloud, waiting to be downloaded.
Your point?
You see what happens to us? Do we live on this planet getting smaller and smaller and smaller? Until we get to the point that we don't even exist? Just the thought of us exists?
You're giving me a headache.
Yeah, I guess it was a stupid thought.
I'm sorry. I think I'm just hungry.
Me too. Hungry for answers. I just want to know.
Why did I do it? Ah! Better yet, why did he do it? I was so stupid for thinking my Prince Charming was on the other end of an internet connection. I will never be able to show my face in school again.
You will never be able to show your face in school again.
Ugh. Who's seen it?
Only everybody.
Oh, shoot me.
There's a meme going on around about it, too.
What does it say?
You don't want to know.
Tell me!
Ah! Oh my god, sorry!
Oh, what did I do to deserve this?
Nothing, nothing at all.
I just want to bury my head.
Dying for yet. This makes Naris immortal. That's all it's gonna do. Fight to end all fights.
Tyler, are you awake?
Laura?
Yeah, Laura.
Am I in the hospital?
Yes.
Good.
No, not good.
Great.
Terrible. You almost died.
Sweet. How many stitches?
I don't know. A lot. Your leg is a mess.
No, not me. The other guy.
You mean the other guys?
There was more than one?
Yes.
You're lucky to be alive.
Lara?
Yes?
Is that you?
Yeah, it's me.
Am I in the hospital?
Yes, you're in the hospital.
Six weeks I was there. Six more in juvenile.
Detention? For real? Do they really think that a locked door is gonna stop me? I mean, like, half of the windows in our pathetic school barely even shut.
You really changed, Nicole. These last few months, it's like I don't even know you anymore.
So you remember that song that Mr. Dick made us listen to in band class? Like, let's make a change, or change is good, or times are a-changin', whatever it was. Change being the key word. And besides, look who's talking, Miss Party Animal.
That was one day. For you, it's a lifestyle.
Mind your own business!
Look, I just don't want you to end up doing something stupid, you know? Something permanent. Something you can't take back.
Or what?
You gonna ground me? All I'm saying is keep this up and you'll end up with no friends.
I have plenty of friends.
Quantity is not the same as quality.
Great, thanks for the tip. Maybe later we can go stitch it on a pillow.
I just don't want you to end up all alone.
Hey! People are finally starting to notice me.
For the wrong reasons.
But they're noticing! And besides, in the end of it all, don't we all end up alone?
Well, you're certainly making sure of it.
I know that was mean. And I'm not even sure if I meant it. But she was drifting away, so why not give her a push? I mean, like, whatever. Things change. People change. Even the seasons change. It's almost
spring.
Ice melts.
Water flows.
Buds arrive.
Flowers bloom.
Children play.
Sunlight lingers.
I used to love the sunset, but now it makes me kind of sad. It marks the end of something. Another day gone, another day by myself. This whole picture thing put up these walls around me that weren't there before, and I don't like it, not one bit. I feel so alone, but I'm scared. To reach out and take a chance on what I know deep down really matters. But still, I blow the sunset a kiss, just in case.
Love. Sure has a way of smacking you across the face. Boy, did I have it all wrong. Turns out Dad's new girlfriend wasn't new at all. She was around long before the divorce. Suddenly, all of Mom's crazy actions make sense. Kind of makes you wonder, who can you trust? Well, I know who you can trust. Nobody. The only person you can look out for is yourself.
All I ever wanted was for someone to be proud of me. When you feel bad about yourself, you look for ways to feel good about yourself, you know? First, it was my body, which, turned out pretty awesome, if I do say so myself. That wasn't enough. My corrections officer, he says I'm making progress. Got tons of programs in here, you know. Carpentry, basketball, painting, even. Funny enough, I'm actually
pretty good at it. Thing is, don't think anyone will notice. Too little. Too late.
I look into the mirror, and I don't recognize myself anymore. Sure, I got everything I ever wanted, like parties, popularity, a life. But now I'm not even sure if I want those things anymore. Can a person try on different personalities to see which one fits? Or do they become permanent fixtures? I can't change the things I've done, but I can change the things I'm going to do. Or at least I can try.
People say I eat my feelings, but they have it backwards. My feelings eat me. I wish there was a measurement for self-esteem, but there's not. I learned that the hard way. 95 hairs in the sink, 95 trips to the doctor, 95 people telling me I'm too skinny. I see the signs, but I need someone to show me the way. I don't think I can make this trip alone.
Lonely is living in the future. Here and now passes you by until a string of yesterdays pile up like snowflakes. Digging yourself out from under them is exhausting. A rejection letter arrived in the mail. It's not like I wasn't expecting it. After all, I brought it upon myself. But don't we all?
My fingernails didn't fall out, but my hair did. A small price to pay, I guess. And I always wanted to be a redhead anyway. I'm not afraid of dying. We all die, so what's there to be afraid of? I just don't want to be by myself when it happens. Especially if it happens when I'm still young. When my grandparents died, my mom was no longer a daughter. When my dad died last year, she was no longer a wife. And if I died, she would no longer be a mother. I wouldn't want her to go through that alone.
Rabbit died this morning. He was old, so I guess it's not exactly a tragedy, but I'll miss him just the same. He was around so that way I wouldn't have to talk to myself. He would listen to all the weird things I had to say and wouldn't judge me for a second. And in doing so, he gave me faith. Faith that people can change. Faith that it's not about how people see you. It's about how you see yourself.
Summer.
on the first day of summer at 4:34 p.m., Laura died. The nurses watched as her mother quietly gathered her belongings into a cardboard box. It was the first time she had ever touched her daughter's phone without a fight. She turned it on.
The screen illuminated, and a smile appeared on her face. The last selfie that Laura took was beautiful. Her eyes twinkled, and the corners of her mouth were turned up. She was alive. And best of all, she wasn't alone.
Caitlin is in love with the sunrise. Watching the sun peek over the horizon to greet the new day is more beautiful than any sunset. Beginnings always are.
Zach sits with Caitlin and takes it all in. Love might not be forever, but right now, it's enough. He's thankful.
Tyler is still awesome. Even more so since he traded his fist in for a paintbrush. He's made his brother proud.
Morgan still feels different. But so does everyone else. He named his new rabbit Tyler, and no longer feels weird about feeling weird.
Jesse knew that there were 220 calories in her ice cream cone, but that was no longer the number she counted. The only number in her mind was number 3. 3 friends and counting.
Nicole looks into the mirror and finally sees what her parents have said was there all along. It turns out, her beauty had nothing to do with her reflection. She turned away from the mirror and never looked back.
A scoop of ice cream toppled from Sam's waffle cone. She looked at it and realized, there's always more ice cream. There's always more everything.
Before Laura died, she looked at her phone and did not like what she saw. So, she snapped one last selfie and released it into the cloud. As she closed her eyes, she thought to herself,
that's better.